Good morning. There are a couple of announcements this morning. Our local food bank needs hygiene products such as shampoo, conditioner, body wash, deodorant, toothpaste, toothbrushes, sanitary products, etc. Our parish CWL is coordinating a monthly donation repository at the entrance of the church before each Mass on the last weekend of each month, beginning February 25th, 26th. We are calling on the generosity of our parishioners to meet the needs of our local food bank. On your way into Mass, please consider dropping off a hygiene item to help those in need. Our parish is looking for new volunteers to be involved in the collection counting that takes place on Sundays following the 10:30 a.m. Mass. If you are interested, please contact the parish office for more information. Thank you.
Good morning and welcome. The hymns for this morning are from the Catholic Book of Worship 3 and Celebrate in Song. They're indicated on the hymn board. Please join in our gathering song from CBW 3, number 601, Gather Us Together.
We continue our reading of the Sacred Scripture, the Beatitudes. Today is a marvelous challenge for all of us. We find in our beautiful readings the key to conform our lives to Christ. It's also our last Sunday of Ordinary Time before the great festivities of Lent. Of course, we want to mark Lent by prayer, fasting, and almsgiving. So just to think about that in our spiritual preparations of some of the things that we'd like to do spiritually and some of the things that we'd like to practice in terms of self-denial. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. As we come together to celebrate these sacred mysteries, our desire is to conform our lives to Christ, to give of ourselves, for God has given us everything. So let us pause together, acknowledging our moments of weakness and our moments when we have failed through sin, to love God and our neighbor. We commend ourselves to the mercy of Almighty God.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, God Almighty Father. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will.
Pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that always pondering spiritual things, we may carry out both in word and in deed that which is pleasing to you, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Leviticus. The Lord spoke to Moses, "Speak to all the congregation of the children of Israel, and say to them, 'You shall be holy, for I, the Lord your God, am holy. You shall not hate in your heart anyone of your kin. You shall reprove your neighbor, or you will incur guilt yourself. You shall not take vengeance or bear a grudge against any of your people, but you shall love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love. He does not deal with us according to our sins, nor repay us according to our iniquities. The Lord is merciful and gracious. As far as the east is from the west, so far he removes our transgressions from us. As a father has compassion for his children, so the Lord has compassion for those who fear him. The Lord is merciful and gracious.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, do you not know that you are God's temple and that God's Spirit dwells in you? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy that person. For God's temple is holy, and you are that temple. Do not deceive yourselves. If you think that you are wise in this age, you should become fools so that you may become wise. For the wisdom of this world is foolishness with God, for it is written, "He catches the wise in their craftiness." And again, "The Lord knows the thoughts of the wise, that they are fertile." So let no one boast about human beings, for all things are yours, whether Paul or Apollos or Cephas, or the world of life or death, or the present of the future, all belong to you. And you belong to Christ, and Christ belongs to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "You have heard that it was said, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. But I say to you, do not resist an evildoer, but if anyone strikes you on the right cheek, turn the other one also. And if anyone wants to sue you and take your coat, give your cloak as well. If anyone forces you to go 1 mile, go with them also the second mile. Give to everyone who begs from you, and do not refuse anyone who wants to borrow from you. You have heard that it was said, you shall love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I say to you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you, so that you may be children of your Father in heaven. For he makes his sun to rise on the evil and on the good, and sends rain on the righteous and on the unrighteous. For if you love those who love you, what reward do you have? Do not even the tax collectors do the same? And if you greet only your brothers and sisters, what more are you doing than others? Do not even the Gentiles do the same? Be perfect, therefore, as your heavenly Father is perfect." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. You belong to Christ, and Christ belongs to God. As we come to have an appreciation and understand how we're to conform our lives to Christ, to St. Paul says, take on the mind of Christ, we search the scriptures and we find what's revealed to us about God. All holy, all powerful, merciful, all loving. But a loving in a magnitude that's very different from human standard. God's love is what we call unconditional. And so, being that way, it's totally gratuitous. There's nothing that human beings can do to earn it, to deserve it, or to merit it. It simply flows from the hand of God, or flows from the heart of God, as it were. Jesus, when he encounters the sinners, always manifests a great love and affection for them, because he understood they were like sheep without a shepherd, and he desired to save them. You belong to Christ, and Christ belongs to God. So we have that sense that that God is always looking out for us, tending to us, always meeting our every need and the deepest desires of our heart. But we hear also that God allows the rains to fall on everyone, both the sinner and the saint, the righteous and the unrighteous. Both the sun rises and sets on those who are good and those who are wicked. It perplexes the mind. It doesn't sort of jive with our human standards or our human perceptions, perhaps, of what should happen. But what's important is what Scripture reveals to us about what God does, that we're not our own, that we are God's children, the beloved of God. And so this conforming really is about trying to take on, as St. Paul says, the mind of God. Now, we can get very theoretical about this.
We can go into an abstract idea of what this looks like. We can get very sort of technical about what it means also to love one's enemies and to do good to those who persecute you. But I want to share with you a story. It's a story of remarkable courage, a story that strikes right to the heart of this matter. In 1869, Fortuna was born in Sudan, Darfur. We don't know really much about her parents, but they called her the fortunate one. We don't know really if she was adopted, or we don't know much about her birth parents. Suffice to say that in around 1877, she was kidnapped, forced into slavery. She was sold as a child, and she went into owners 12 different times over the course of 12 different years. She suffered much oppression at the hands of her owners. Now, some were kind to her, but others treated her with great malice. She suffered 114 scars at the hand of a Turkish general's wife and mother, beat her on a daily basis. But under God's providence, she was sold and bought by an Italian, a general a counselor, or something of that nature. And well, he was in Africa, but then he also had to go back to Venice, Italy, where he lived part of the time. And he was conducting business, and so Fortuna asked if she could please go with him. This could be her gateway out of this whole business of having to be a slave. So he conceded, and she went to Venice, Italy. And there, the family that she was staying with, the husband had to go on business, and so they placed her in the hands of the Consinara sisters, the missionary sisters. Well, in Italy, she discovered her freedom. She discovered Jesus Christ. The beautiful story unfolds. She asked the sisters to help her plead her cause because she didn't want to be a slave anymore. She wanted to be free. And so they took the case to court, and it was discovered that in Sudan, slavery had been abolished even before she was born. She took the name Josephine. She became a consecrated sister, and her fellow sisters found her to be very gentle. Now, I find that striking, considering how her childhood was taken away from her. She suffered grave abuse, neglect. She was under certain, you know, pains, obviously, from these scars that she bore not only just on her body, but imagine what her sense of her fellow man was, especially those who mistreated her. The sisters found her gentle. They called her affectionately and reverently Black Mother. Well, the sisters got to know her very well, and there was a time when they asked her, Sister Josephine, what would you do if you ever met those who sold you into slavery, those who beat you and tortured you? What would you do to them? And she said this, I would kneel down, I would kiss their hand, and I would thank them. For without them, I wouldn't be a Christian. I wouldn't be a sister today. And there's someone who understood the teaching of Jesus to love our enemies. Let us rise together in response to God's holy word and profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, Holy Catholic Church, communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. We recognize and celebrate the kindness and compassion of our God. We pray for that same unconditional love, forgiveness, that we would extend that to our enemies and those who have betrayed or hurt us. We offer prayers for those in the church, especially those preparing for the sacraments. We pray for those who struggle with compassion, mercy, and reconciliation.
For the church, temple of God's holiness, and witness to self-giving love as it proclaims God's mighty deeds in the Eucharist. For all ministers who reflect God's holiness to their people, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the forgiveness of all injuries and pursuits of love for our enemies, for government leaders amid the challenges they face in pursuing justice and peace for their citizens, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the pursuit of God's wisdom and peace throughout the world, for the injured, grieving, and homeless people of Syria and Turkey, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our pursuit of holiness and love during the coming Lenten season, for those who sow the seeds of love and reconciliation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all disciples of Jesus who seek to grow in love for God and one another as they prepare for initiation into the church, for the sick, hospitalized, homebound and burdened, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the spiritual and physical well-being of all parishioners, for Terry Shea and Tom Willinis, those who have died recently, including Brian Gilroy, and for all who show compassion to us and God's children, in memory of Raymond and Lois Allen, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, hear our prayers. You are the source of all holiness. Teach us to renounce violence, vengeance. Teach us to love our enemies and to do good to those who persecute us. We ask all this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Those who live in pain, God. is the Lord, slow to anger, rich in love. God remembers not our sins, forgiving and loving is God. Loving and forgiving are you, O Lord, slow to anger, rich in kindness, loving and
that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. The Lord accept the sacrifice for our hands, praise the Lord of his name, our good and all his holy church. As we celebrate your mysteries, O Lord, with the observance that is your due, we humbly ask you that what we offer to the honor of your majesty may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just. It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty, eternal God, through Christ our Lord, word of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself, was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death. And by rising the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels, archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray. By sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, to be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Michael, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, blessed apostles, Saint Francis, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you, your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the age of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
The Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace, O Lord, with you always. Let's offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, not for the use done unto my roof, but only the word of my soul shall be healed.
Oh,
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we may experience the effects of the salvation which is pledged to us by these mysteries. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. Thanks be to God. With the season of Lent on the horizon, we have the 22nd of February, Ash Wednesday, as a day of imposition of the holy ashes. There's a Mass at 8:30 in the morning, at noon, and at 7 p.m. The evening Mass will have a holy hour at 6 o'clock, so please avail yourself to one of those masses. If you're traveling and you want to know the times of the masses for the location, I know there's a couple parishioners who are traveling, and we can call the office. We'll look it up online, and we'll find out for you. As we begin the season of Lent, we know it's a season of grace, a prayer, fasting, and almsgiving. And, parishioners are thinking about things they would like to do. And to remember that we really want to do it for God, for God's glory. So I recommend a couple of things to do, such as maybe coming to a daily Mass, for example. There's the rosary to pray at home. There's the Divine Mercy chaplet. You could offer that chaplet from time to time. We have the Stations of the Cross are going to be offered on Wednesday, We'll have that at 4:30 p.m. every Wednesday during Lent, and then we'll celebrate the Holy Mass at 5 o'clock. Every Friday, we'll have, with the exception of Good Friday, the stations at 8:30, followed by the Holy Mass at 9 o'clock. So there's going to be announcements about our local penance celebrations in different churches. Our penance celebration will be Sunday, the 26th of March at 3 p.m. And of course, we'll have lots of priests here. We pray for good weather because the Advent penance celebration, there were 8 priests here, but the weather wasn't very cooperative. So I think we'll have much better weather, and we really want to pray for each other that this would be a season of grace, to pray for healing and strength, to pray for our families, and that we'll have that holy time together. Our prayer to St. Michael. St. Michael, the archangel, defend us in battle, bear defense against the wickedness and the snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And thou, O Prince of heavenly hosts, the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Amen.